Okay, here's where we're going today. We've parked here. We're just gonna follow this around. And then we're gonna go over here to the spillway. Should be a lot of water. Right here's the actual spillway. So probably about 3 miles total today. Let's get hiking. Okay, so I'm on trail here at Huntsville State Park, heading over to the spillway. Past few days, we've probably had 5 or 6 inches of rain. There's a lot of water in the park. So we'll take a look at that. It's a little after 3 o'clock. It's about 45 degrees outside and getting colder. I'm bundled up pretty good. The only thing I wish I would have had were my gloves. But I should be fine. The lake, it's looking pretty muddy with all the rain. But a lot of tent campers out here. I'll show pictures later. Okay, this is pretty amazing. I don't think I've ever seen this many people on this trail ever. 10 minutes on, and I bet I've passed 70 or 80 people. But then again, I'm going clockwise and everyone else is going counterclockwise. See how it goes. Okay, so this is the first time I've seen this much water over this trail. Looks like they've had some erosion. Last time I was on this trail, it was all green and lush and 85, 90 degrees. Not today. So far, the only thing that's cold are my hands. Let's see where we want to go. Okay, so we're here. We're going to take this trail on the right, go down around here to the spillway, and then on the way back, we'll take the Triple C trail along the perimeter boundary, just so we get a different viewpoint. My neck gaiter is keeping me pretty warm. Nose and eyes are kind of the only thing exposed. I've got my thin hiking pants on. My legs aren't cold. I've got a thermal shirt on. And then my down jacket. But I've got another shirt in my pack just in case. So far I'm doing pretty good. When I left this morning, or should I say early afternoon, sun was out and it was about 55-56, but then this cloud layer came in and the temperature dropped really fast. My back is doing really well. I got my hiking stick. I'm feeling very good today. It's good to get out. Miss my partner. Wish she was here. So I thought the weight of my day pack would irritate my lower back where the incisions are. But being that my pack is padded and it's just applying a slight amount of pressure, actually feels very good. I will let you know how I feel after I'm done today. That's the $20,000 question. It'll be interesting to see what my mile time is. Before surgery, I was averaging 20, 22 minutes per mile. I've got all trails running in the background to capture my movements today. So I'll get up here in a minute and insert a screen grab of what I've done so far. this is what I enjoy. Quiet. The disconnect. The sounds of nature. And everybody needs someone to share moments like this. Today, everybody has been fantastic that I've run across. Very, very busy. Friendly, the stopping and talking, no masks. Gives you more confidence in humanity. You know, people that make the effort to come out and hike and get outdoors, especially so many new people, and realizing the relief that you get from communing with nature, the disconnect from the day-to-day grind. And no matter how many miles you hike, at the end of the day, you could be sore as hell, but you're very relieved. I had to cut out for a second. I won't put others in my videos. I respect their privacy. And get to do a lot of reflecting while you're out here, especially on New Year's Day. So we're at the spillway. I've never seen this much water. This road right here comes around here and up. Last time I was here, you could walk over that. You could walk over the top of the spillway. And then the alligators would be sleeping out here underneath the shade. Never seen this sight. We're going to head downstream and look at the creek. So we're coming up to the creek downstream of the spillway. And I always thought that the sandbars down here would be a beautiful place for a picnic. Problem today is there's no sandbars. Right there would be a great place to have a picnic. If it was about 30, 40 degrees warmer. All right. Let's turn around and we'll head back. We're going to take the Triple C Trail along the perimeter of the property, or the perimeter of the state park. and then head back to the truck. Probably be at the truck right as it gets dark. It's really overcast, 100% overcast right now. It feels like it's probably 41 degrees. So, let's take a look at the map. So, I am now on the Triple C Trail, which essentially follows the entire perimeter of the park. There won't be any people on this trail. There never is. Maybe bikes, but I don't think today. Okay, so we're now on the Triple C Trail, which is essentially the perimeter of the park. You could drive a four-wheel drive vehicle across the entire perimeter of the park. There's the far end. There's a perimeter fence
probably a fire gate. And that's where I'm heading. It's about 4:40 right now. It's gonna be getting dark quick. So like I said, I'll probably be at the truck when it gets dark. So I may have to bust out the headlamp here in a bit. So let's continue. I haven't seen any wildlife. I haven't seen any birds, squirrels, any signs of boars. Here's a better shot of the fence line at the edge of the park. Wow, looks like the woodpeckers have been getting at this one. They knocked off some big pieces too. No nests. Well, maybe one. Interesting.
I've seen no one on the Triple C trail since I've been on it. Not even any footprints. All right, so I'm turning off of the Triple C trail, which is this. Short jaunt up, make the left, and go right to where the truck is. You know when you get that gut feeling that something's wrong and you don't realize it? Then you pull out the map and found out you turned too early and that you might be going around in circles. Yeah, I just did that. It's not the first time. Definitely will not be the last time. Well, apparently I was not the only one that missed their turn. These two ladies in front of me did the exact same thing. So I don't feel as bad. The camera doesn't show it, but it's getting pretty dark fast. I've got about a third of a mile to go before I get to the truck. One last view of the terrain and the quiet, peaceful. It's been a day of reflection. What you did in the past year, all of the good, all of the bad, what are you gonna do in the future? To fix the mistakes that you've made, to take advantage of all the advancements that you've made. Do more things. Visit more places. Today is one of those days of reflection. It's been 5 weeks since my back surgery. I'm doing very well. I am not where I want to be, though, physically or emotionally.
or even this current location. But that is of my own doing. And I need to correct that. I just hope it can be fixed. When you live your life like I do and keep your emotional walls up, sometimes you don't realize what you have in front of you. And then you make that one error. And it all comes apart.